Your car may not start for a variety of reasons, but what does it mean when clicking is also present? If your car clicks when attempting to start, a straightforward solution to a challenging issue may be in order. In this video, we cover the reasons why you may hear clicking when you turn the key. We also give you a few solutions to the issue. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Here is a more detailed list of reasons why your car clicks when trying to start it. Bad starter. You will hear a single clicking noise if the starter or its relay malfunctions. It won't produce the same sound as a dead battery. Although they are designed to last up to 200,000 miles, starters occasionally break down. Depending on your local climate, the starter might break down much sooner than it should. Low battery voltage. To start the car engine, your car battery must be fully charged. The battery's capacity to hold a steady charge will decrease with age. When you try to start the car engine, you might only hear a quick clicking sound if it has grown too weak. A failing automotive alternator may be the cause of the issue if the battery is more recent and there is no explanation for why it is dead. The battery must be charged by the alternator, which is prone to failure after 100,000 miles or more. Loose or corroded battery terminals. Even when a battery is not dead, clicking can mimic a dead battery. If so, a loose connection to the battery terminal may be the cause of the issue. Additionally, the terminal connections may be corroded. Vibration from the road causes connections to become loose. Electrolytes or vapors escaping from the top of the battery cause corrosion. Both of these issues are easily fixed. Broken power cable. Power cables carry the voltage from the battery to all of the electronics. The car won't start if a power cable breaks because it won't send the proper voltage. Overusing cables causes them to break over time. Excessive wear can also be brought on by weather conditions and vehicle vibration. There is no need to play around with a broken cable. It should be fixed or replaced as soon as possible. Bad ground strap. The ground strap is the black wire that attaches the battery's negative terminal to the car's frame. It is also referred to as a negative battery cable, ground wire, or ground cable. The electrical system of the car is supported by this strap. A ground strap is also present between the engine and the chassis of the vehicle. The car may not start when the ground connection is broken, but you might hear a clicking noise instead. Additionally, you might start experiencing issues with the accessories and notice lights that flicker. Take note of everything that happens because this issue may cause some unusual symptoms. How to fix? The first step in solving the issue is identifying the source of the clicking noise. Once you've done that, you can either use the steps below or consult the service manual to find the correct repair methods. Charge the car battery. The car won't be able to start the engine if the battery has died. This occurs when the lights are left on or if the battery is not being charged by the alternator. It might also happen if a maintainer was left off when you put the car in storage. There are many choices available to you. If you are stranded and need to jumpstart your car, choose this option. After that, let the engine run for at least 20 minutes to recharge the battery. If the battery has died while you are away, another option is to use a portable jumper. Once more, you must let the engine run for the battery to be charged by the alternator. If you have the patience to wait for the battery to charge, connecting a battery charger is your best bet. Install a trickle charger if your car is in storage or isn't used frequently. This is a great option. Look for damaged or corroded cables. Check for corrosion at the battery terminals. For a better connection, you should clean up any white buildup on the terminals that you notice. Apply a solution of water and baking soda to the terminals. It should be simple to remove with a toothbrush and some gentle pressure. Here are a few safety recommendations. Because the corrosion can burn your skin, wear protective gloves. Another preventative measure you might think about is wearing safety glasses. You can also use a cotton swab if you don't have an old toothbrush on hand. Simply avoid using your fingers or a rag that you intend to keep. After cleaning the terminals, if any debris remains, think about using compressed air to spray it off. Carefully dispose of all equipment. Battery acid is corrosive and dangerous, and it can harm many things. You should also look for any loose connections. To see if the car starts, tighten up any loose connections. Furthermore, if any of the cables are worn out or harmed, replace them right away. The process of replacing an outdated cable with a new one is quick. Replace the car battery. 3 to 5 years are the maximum lifespan of a car battery. You must change it once it can no longer hold a charge. A nearby auto parts store will test your car's battery. Additionally, if you buy the battery from one of these places, many of them will replace it at no cost to you. Depending on its specification, a new car battery can cost anywhere from $75 to $450. If you replace the battery and the issue still persists, the alternator is probably to blame. Replace it to make sure the battery receives the necessary charge. The cost to replace the alternator professionally ranges from $200 to $700. Tap the starter with a hammer. An electric motor with deteriorating graphite brushes serves as the starter. Rust may develop in the housing if moisture enters. A light tap on the starter housing may help to clear the obstruction. This is only a short-term solution. Permanent magnets may be used in the starter in place of electric ones. The magnets could break if you strike the starter too forcefully. When that occurs, your only option will be to replace the starter. Because of this, you should proceed with caution and tap it lightly. It is best to replace the starter once it starts to malfunction. A starter replacement could cost between $175 and $450. Contact a professional. You might have some mechanical knowledge and believe it will be simple to fix the starting issue. It's possible that after some diagnostic work and attempted repairs, you'll realize it's too much for you. Accepting defeat is acceptable, especially if you are not familiar with the systems you are using. Find a reputable local mechanic by doing some research. Before approving any work, the Federal Trade Commission advises getting an estimate. Additionally, look for a mechanic who provides some sort of warranty. Some retailers provide a warranty on the parts, while others also cover labor costs in the event of a problem. Hope the information was useful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.